In this video, I'm going to show you how to get started doing the isometric exploded assembly for the toe stop project. So this is the ultimate assembly that we're going to end up doing. It's all in isometric, and I'm going to walk you through in a series of videos how to draw each one of those components. We're going to start with the isometric base. I'm going to zoom out a little bit so you can see I'm using the template that you were given. The assembly is where we're going to draw this isometric assembly, but I've already got the details drawn out. So I've got the base, front view, top view, side view with dimensions. I've got the cleat pin, and then I've got the cleat detailed over here. So it's important when you do isometrics, even though that's going to be the first page on your project, it's going to actually be the last thing that you draw in this project. So the reason for that is if we have to pull any dimensions, if we aren't given something that's really obvious or specific in the sketch, we can always go back to our own drawing and pull a dimension from there, especially when it comes to things like the countersink. You know, it gives us an 82 degrees for an angle, but it doesn't tell us what that actual depth comes out to be. So we can always come back to our drawing and take dimensions from there. So I'm going to just pan over here, and I'm just going to get started off to the side. Like I said, this video, we're just going to cover the base, and it's just going to be the overall shape of the base. I'll do another video about the counter bores and the countersink and the hole. I'll do another video just showing how to do this little cutaway here. So we're just going to worry about kind of the overall shape of that base in this video. All right, so I'll just kind of scooch this over here. I do have a help sheet that I'm going to keep referring back to. And this help sheet, it's got the exploded assembly here. And again, we're just working on the base for now. And this worksheet is going to walk us through the dimensions that we need to know. We can also refer back to, oops, if I were to bring it over here. This is actually what I'm going to just keep up on my other screen. You have this in your book. This is exactly the sketch from the book, but I'm going to keep this over here. So you can always refer back to the initial sketch if you need to pull any dimensions from there. So I'm going to just keep that on my other screen over here as I get started. So first of all, I have to put myself into isometric mode. I can easily do that. Lots of ways, or a couple of ways that you can get that done. But nowadays, the easiest way to do it is just to click on this little button down here. We learned this when we learned about chapter 7 when we did our isometrics. But I just turn that on, and you can see now my cursor changed and I've got an isometric cursor. Now, step number two, and I hope you remember this. I know it might have been a short time since you've actually done an isometric lately, but we do need to make sure we not only set our cursor to be in that isometric snap, but we also need to turn on our ortho. Remember that ortho. When we start drawing a line, we need to make sure, I'm going to draw a line here just to remind you, we got to make sure that we're really, really, really going at these angles. If I need to come up here, remember F5 is our new BFF. We've got it. We can come here, and here you can be in the middle of a command and type in that F5. So as I go through this, I'll remind you of some of the little tricky things, like stuff that you can't do, stuff that you can do. Let's go back to this original sketch here. So I'm just going to get started with this basic shape. We're going to start with the isocircle. Remember, it's not a circle and it's not really an ellipse. It's an isocircle. So we're going to get started with that isocircle. Looking at my sketch, I know that these circles have a radius of 2. So I'll come back to AutoCAD and I'm going to get started on the isocircle with a radius of 2. So we're going to do the axis end circle, our ellipse command. So when you pull this down, don't go for center. It has to be the one called axis end. And now it wants to saying specify the axis endpoint. Remember, this is where we have to type I enter for isocircle. So I enter. You could have also done the little down arrow on your keyboard to get to that option as a pull down. So we'll click here. And remember, we can hit F5. So we've got the 3 different isocircles. We've got iso left, iso top, iso right. We're just toggling between those 3 until we get the one that we want. It wants the radius. So I will type in my radius is just a 2. Pretty straightforward. Now I do know that this circle here is going to be copied down. Remember that base has a depth of 2. You guys just did that in your multi-view drawing. So we're going to end up copying this down with a distance of 2. Before I do that, I'm actually going to do a little tricky thing here. I am going to draw a line from the center out a distance of 2. So that radius, really. And now that I've got that done, I'm gonna copy that circle. Remember, we can't offset, so we gotta do copy. So I'm gonna select it, copy anywhere for a base point, it doesn't matter. And I'm gonna, every time I do this, I really, really exaggerate how far I go out because inevitably, O snaps get me. So I don't want any O snaps to accidentally pull me into them and get me. So I'm gonna pull it out, my radius of 2. I'm gonna pull it this way, a radius of 2. So now the reason I did it that way is because I wanted to be able to draw a perfectly tangent line coming right out there. I don't need this guy anymore. We'll just go ahead and delete that. So now that I've got this overall shape, let's go ahead and close it off. And looking good, looking good. So let's take this whole thing and we're gonna copy it down. Hit F5 so I can go down. And I'm gonna copy this a distance of 2. All right, this is looking good. Now we're gonna draw some lines. We're just gonna go straight up from, go ahead and make sure you have your quadrant O snap on. So quadrant to quadrant. And now we can come back here and start trimming this thing. Oops, we need one more line, don't we? We really don't need this line. I'll end up going back and erasing it later, but we really don't need that line, but just to kind of close it off so we have a kind of a visual here. All right, looks good. So I'm gonna go ahead and trim, and we're just gonna trim all this business out of here. So it's perfectly smooth on top, here and here. We don't need that one, here, here, and here. So now we've got kind of the front end of this so that we can, just see what we've got going on here. So this looks good. The front end, I've got a diameter of 4, radius of 2, however you want to think of it. Now we're going to go ahead and start working our way backwards. So I'm going to take this line right here. And remember I said that we don't really have that line. If we come back and look at this and look at I don't have a straight line right there. So I'm gonna take this line and I'm just gonna copy it back a distance. And that distance, if I look at my sketch, remember that's 2.125. So I'm gonna take this vertical line, copy it back 2.125. So copy anywhere for a base point. I need to go this way, so I gotta hit F5, 2.125. Okay, looking good. Well, I should have moved, but whatever. And now I can extend. Remember, trim and extend. They're kind of buried inside of each other. So I'm gonna extend that out. I really don't need this anymore. All right, so this is looking good. Now, this whole thing has an overall height of 4. So I have this, if I hover it right here, it says it's an overall height of 2. I need an overall height of 4. We're gonna come back to this one. What I'm actually gonna do is draw, coming up here, I'm gonna draw my overall height of 2. So I've already got 2, I'm gonna add 2 on top. All right, this is the tricky part. So we're gonna get to the good stuff right now. I've got this, I'm gonna draw this front little area right here. And to do that, I'm gonna come up, I've already come up my distance of 2. I know that it's gonna go over a distance of 1, down a distance of 0.58. And we know that it's 0.58. If you go to, at no point in our original sketch does it say 0.58. But if you come over into your drawing where you did the multi-view, you can take that distance, go, you know, do your distance command, and you can find that that's a 0.58. So we're gonna go over 1, down 0.58, and then back up. And that's gonna define that angle for us. So let's do that. We're gonna go over 1. F5, 1, we're gonna go down 0.58, and then we're just gonna go back to where we started. You could also, I could snap to the endpoint there, or I can type C for close. Just when you type C for close, it just goes back to wherever you started that, in, that line command. So this looks good. I can delete that out, and I have got my angle right there. I can do the same thing on the other side. So we'll come over here. We're going to go up 2, over 1, down 0.58. And I'm not gonna say C for close because that'll take me back to that original corner. So I'll go ahead and snap to that corner. Looks good, nice. Okay, so I am almost done here. We have a couple more dimensions. I do know that, let's see, I'm gonna pull this sketch over so we can talk about this. All right, so I've got these guys drawn. I do know from the very top, it goes down 1.25, and that's this line right here. I don't really want to draw a construction line and bring that down, but I do know this is 2. So we'll just take 1.25 from 2, and so we're going to bring this line that we already have drawn up 0.75. So let's just mosey over here. We're going to copy this up a distance of 0.75. Looking good. And lots of ways you can do this. I'm just going to draw a line. We can bring it, you can't really snap to perpendicular because we're in isometric. It does that weird thing. So you can exaggerate how big that line is, and we'll just go back and trim it. Or you could copy, you know, your existing line here down. Either way, we're going to go trim it, so it doesn't really matter how you do that. Let's go trim. I like to trim as I go. I don't want to get confused with lots of lines and grids and everything everywhere. So this is looking really good. Let's come over here and do another line. We know that this goes back. Remember, that was the 2.125 or 2.25. 2.125, all right, get it straight. 2.125, make sure you type that correctly because once you do it, we're just gonna copy that line. So you gotta make sure it's right. But this looks good. We're gonna copy it here and here and here and here. Oh my gosh, this is looking so good. So now we're gonna copy some more. We're gonna take this line back. Looks good. We're going to copy this line back. Oh my goodness. We are going to copy this line. Oops, pick it up somewhere. Endpoint. Make sure you're picking it up at the endpoint. My OSnap wasn't wanting to give it to me, but I had to force it. We're going to copy this line back. Looking good. We're going to bring this line up. A distance, it should be an initial, you know, it's already at 2. I had that at 2 already. We can bring that up. It should be a 4. So I could use the stretch command and bring it to the end. Or I can click on it. This is pretty cool. If you click that grip, I can type an additional dimension 2, and it'll now make that line 4. Or I'm just showing you lots of cool things you can do here. You can click here. Here's where I can add a dimension. If I press tab, I can just override what that says. So now instead of adding an additional 2 to that 2, I could just type in 4 here. Lots of ways you can do it. Anything, there's so many ways to do any one thing in AutoCAD. There is no right way or wrong way. We're gonna trim this out, and my goodness, this is looking like a really nice base. So, that is all that we're going to do for this video. I'm going to come back in the next video and we're going to tackle that countersink that is here. We're going to tackle that counter bore. And we're also going to figure out that little hole that's off in the side over here for the cleat pin to go through. So, but this looks great. Oops, you know what? One thing I did not do. Do we have an isometric layer? Oh my goodness, yes, please. I should have done that in the video, at the beginning of the video. They're the same color, so it's easy to get that confused, but we want to make sure that we're doing all of this on the isometric layer. So let's set it all on isometric. Let's make sure that we have the isometric layer set current. And yeah, this looks great. So join me for the next video when we do some counter bores and counter sinks and a through hole, and then we'll move on from there.